Hello, I'm Nick Simmons, County Extension Director and Commercial Livestock Agent for the University of Florida IFAS Extension in Escambia County.
Hi, I'm Libbie Johnson, Escambia County Agriculture Agent, and we're out here in Molino, Florida, and we're in an annual field of millet.
So today we want to talk about one of the more important aspects of grazing management, and that's understanding grazing height and rotational grazing. One of the main things that we see a lot of producers is that they simply don't pull the cattle off of grass to let it regrow, get back to an optimum height, and what we can see is weed pressure move in when this occurs.
So one of the tools that we use to determine when's the proper time to move cattle out and move to another pasture is this grazing stick that you can get at your local NRCS office. Nick is going to show you, by measuring the height, this measures about 15 to 16 inches, and you can look on the side of the stick. There's guidelines for rotational grazing of selected forages, and it gives you an indication of at what height you should move the animals off to another pasture.
So this is a really simple tool that you can keep in your truck, you can throw it in the toolbox, and when you question, you know, is it time to move the cattle out, you can walk out here, kind of sample at different places throughout the field so that you get a better estimate of the entire field. And you know, it's one of those simple things where you can really make your summer forages last longer as we start transitioning into winter supplementation and winter grazing. This is one of those things that will just prolong your grazing season.
So Nick, I would like to point out, and you and I have discussed this a number of times, about why you don't want to graze too low. A lot of producers sometimes get in a situation where they have to keep grazing because they don't have another pasture ready to go. But what kind of damage do you think it does to the overall health of the field and the pasture when you graze your forage too short?
Well, I think there's two things that really can happen. You get a lot of trampling effect by simply keeping the animals on the pasture for a prolonged period. Mm-hmm. Plus, you also take down the plant material to a very low stubble height. And you know, like you know, the plant generates its energy from having exposure and having plant material. And when you take that away, you can take away root integrity, you can take away the plant strength. And so ultimately you're causing more damage than you need to. And so what that can result in is having to do more supplementation, more feeding, pulling in hay a lot sooner. And so your cost ultimately starts going up because of mismanagement of your forage.
I think a really good thing that you pointed out was about the roots. You should really think about how much plant matter you have above corresponds to how much root matter you have below. You really need good, healthy roots to take up nutrients and water. Without that, your plant's not going to grow nearly as well as it could. And in a permanent pasture like bahia grass, if you continually overgraze, your roots get greatly diminished. So it's very important, especially in permanent pasture, to try to keep as much as you can going with the root system.
So the take-home message for today is to understand that there is management in simply moving cattle on and off the grass to rest the grass, cut down on trampling effects and overgrazing, and to ultimately prolong your grazing season. Now, if you have more questions about this, you can certainly reach out to your local UF IFAS Extension office or visit us online at solutionsforyourlife.com.